The tip of the spear in a revolution that would change the landscape of pulp culture. Superman has spent the last 80 years redefining what it means to stand for truth, justice, and the American way. The last survivor of the doomed planet Krypton, raised in the quiet heartland of Smallville, Kansas, Superman is as much of a legend as he is a man. The gold standard of heroism, compassion, and responsibility. Though his powers make him godlike next to his human compatriots, Superman's story is not one of greed or conquest. Instead, he strives to represent the inherent goodness of the human spirit and the capacity of every living thing to do right by their neighbors. What's going on, guys? Multiverse here with yet another action figure review video, and today we're going to be taking a look at the Mcfarlane Collector's Edition Superman by Mcfarlane Toys. Starting off this video, guys, we are of course taking a look at that Mcfarlane packaging. And it is of course black, silver, and blue with the open face window, seeing the Action Comics first look at Superman looking absolutely beautiful with DC Multiverse down here at the bottom, as well as Superman's name with the 85 year Superman logo over here. Congratulations on 85 years, Superman. You're one of the good ones. Flipping over to the side, we see Mcfarlane Collector's Edition Superman from Action Comics number one. Flipping over to the back, guys, is that iconic Superman image of him picking up the car, and it just is so classic. Looks absolutely beautiful. I love this image. Flipping over to the side, guys, not really much going on other than more logos and Superman's name, as well as a number one down here. Definitely gonna have to take a deep dive into the Mcfarlane Collector's Edition. Nothing going on at the top, and then down here at the bottom is the barcode for you barcode guys. With all that said, guys, let's go ahead and rip the Man of Steel out of his packaging and see how he looks. So right here, guys, standing straight up and down on the rotating turntable is the Mcfarlane Collector's Edition first appearance Superman. And for my first-hand impressions on the Superman, I think he looks good. However, I'm not a really big fan of the face. And then, of course, we see the reused Superman body mold that we're all sick of. However, I really do love this figure. I think he does look amazing. And it is an absolute Mcfarlane blessing that we got an original Superman from his very first appearance. He looks absolutely phenomenal. I do love the attack that Mcfarlane did on this figure. He looks good. Not great, but he does look good. With all that said, guys, let's go ahead and move him off of the rotating turntable and take a closer look at the accessories that he came with. When it comes to the accessories, guys, I will say for a Mcfarlane Collector's Edition, I am a little let down. In terms of accessories, as you see, he comes with a lot, but it's more of like a whole bunch of nothing. Starting off like we always do, guys, here is his trading card. It says Mcfarlane's Collector's Edition in that beautiful silver with that infamous comic cover of Superman lifting the car. Flipping over to the back, guys, is the read-up if you want to pause the screen and read it right now. Always give you guys that little bit of a second. He does, of course, come with a standard Mcfarlane base, although this one's a little bit different. It is, of course, the black circle we know and love, and then we have a silver DC logo just stamped right there front and center. Also, guys, he does come with another stand, which is a flight stand. So I do love seeing two different types of stand for this figure. It is, of course, the little waist grabber for the flight stand, but this one does have the black DC logo in the clear reflection down there, or the clear base down at the bottom. So that does really pop and looks amazing. He does, of course, come with another stand, and this is an all black stand, and it's got some detail in there. Feels nice. It's not like a cheap plastic. You can tell it is sturdy, and it's got a big, beautiful DC logo, just silver painted on top of there. And this is, of course, the card holder. So if you take the card and just slide it on in there, you can go whichever way you want. But I personally will be displaying these figures cards with the cover front and center with the read-up covered on the back. And then last but not least, guys, when it comes to accessories, he does, of course, come with a chain that wraps around him. You can kind of make it look like he's been trapped by Lex Luthor, or make it look like he is breaking out because he is the Man of Steel. And this chain link is beautifully detailed. They are soft plastic that are just like molded together, so it is beautifully done. I will say, however, for this to be a Mcfarlane collector's edition, I want more accessories. I want head swaps and I want extra hands if I'm going to be paying the $30 price point when it comes to these figures. Now, I've seen other videos, everybody's talking about how when it comes with more, but it's like a whole bunch of nothing. They are absolutely right. This is great. I will say I do like the extra stands. I want more for the figure, because at the end of the day, the figure is what we are buying, not just this here. With all that said though, guys, let's go ahead and move away from the accessories and take a closer look at the figure himself to see that detail. In terms of detail, guys, starting off with the head sculpt, I will say I'm not a big fan of this head sculpt here. I don't really like how his eyes are kind of constantly squinting. He always looks like the sun is blinding him, like it's just in his face. I get it's supposed to be representation for how he was drawn. However, you don't have to do that. You know, it's only drawn like that because it's such a small image that they're trying to sketch. I would say, you know, brighten this up, give him more facial expressions. But in terms of the detail, guys, I do love the wrinkles they gave him around his mouth here. Although he's not really, I mean, he's kind of smirking, but he doesn't really have like a grin going on. So I don't know why there's so many wrinkles. Maybe he's, you know, 85 years old. Congratulations, you know, another year Superman. However, I'm not a big fan of all the wrinkles around his mouth, but I do like that they are there. You know, that attention to detail is there. Going down here now, guys, looking at his chest. Once again, not really much going on that we haven't seen before in terms that this is the same Superman body mold that we've seen time and time again. Although I do love that S on that little classic shield going on. That looks good. But in terms of detail here, guys, it's just the muscles and then the ripples throughout the suit. Now, I do love that Mcfarlane is doing this for some of his figures. It gives us that old look where they wear the tight spandex, how they started. It is coming from the roots of these characters, and I actually like that. Going down here now, guys, looking at his crotch piece, we do see that this is the underwear and belt from, I want to say, the Superman 1000 that came out. I want to say that this is what this is from, because obviously the belt loops are not painted. I remember when I had that one. I don't have it anymore, but I remember when I had that one, the belt loops were not painted on it. So I want to say this is a reuse from that one down there, but it does still look absolutely beautiful. Just a little paint strokes can fix that right up, and he will look absolutely amazing. Going down here now, guys, looking at the legs. They are the same legs that we've seen time and time again, and as well as the boots. They're just not painted. They're all painted the one color. Although I don't get it. This Superman kind of has like ankle boots going on here for his first appearance, and he doesn't have the yellow belt either, or at least not in this image here that they're going off of. He doesn't have the yellow belt. I personally would have probably tried to molded some, you know, the red ankle boots down there just for a callback for this here. However, it still looks good. I love this color blue. They went with that lighter blue and it's like a dark red and a light blue. So it still looks good. With all that said, guys, let's go ahead. Oh, actually, before we move, let's go ahead and take a look at the cape. Now, the cape is how they've been doing it, but it is still beautifully detailed. I love the ripples of the cape showing it flowing in the wind off to the side. Looks absolutely amazing. Although I would have added the Superman S on the back. We need more Supermans with the S on the back. With all that said, guys, let's go ahead and zoom away from the figure himself and take a look at his size, articulation, and get into some size comparison. When it comes to how tall Superman stands, guys, Superman does stand at the top of the head. It looks like exactly 7 inches tall. So he is the standard Mcfarlane 7 inches. Let's go ahead and take him off of his base here and jump into some articulation. Starting off with his head, he can look up all the way and looks down about that far. He is on a ball joint, so he gets some good head tilt, and his head does rotate all the way around. His arms, they do come with a useful butterfly joint. Although, there it goes. It was a little stiff, but now it can rotate all the way around. His arms go up about that far, and they do rotate all the way around. He does come with a bicep swivel as well as double hinged elbows. There we go. Double hinge it out. Going down here now, guys, looking at his hands, they are on a hinge, so they do hinge up and down and rotate all the way around. Looking at Superman's ab crunch, guys, his ab crunch is typical Mcfarlane, non-existent, but I bet he is the limbo master at the DC parties. Going out here now, guys, looking at his waist swivel. His waist swivel is there, rotates all the way around. His legs go out about that far. They go back about that far, although they're stuck by the Superman buttocks. Double hinge knees, and his ankles do articulate down. They articulate up. he has toe articulation, and he does, of course, have that beautiful ankle pivot. Starting off with the size comparison, guys, here we have the Action Comics number one Superman standing next to the Superman from the Batman Hush storyline. Did a little bit of a head swap on here. But as you can see, these two do stand beautifully together. Kind of like a how it started and a how it's going. Looks absolutely phenomenal side by side. I will say I do notice this one is a little bit taller, but the scale still works. Next up, guys, here we have Superman standing next to another DC classic look with Jay Garrick. And as you can see, these two do scale beautifully. Jumping out of the DC Universe, guys, and right into the Marvel Universe, here we have Superman standing next to the MCU Tom Holland Homecoming Spider-Man. And as you can see, these two actually do scale beautifully together. And last but not least, guys, here we have Superman standing next to the Marvel Legends Iron Man. And as always, you can see this scale simply does not work. Alrighty, guys, and there you have it. Another action figure review video in the books on my channel for you guys to enjoy. When it comes to my final review on this Mcfarlane Collector's Edition Superman, I'm gonna have to give him a solid 7 out of 10. Don't get me wrong, I do love this figure and he does look good. However, I'm just not feeling that face. I do love the cape, but I've said it before, I'll say it again, and I'm like the rest of you, I am sick and tired of this body mold. I really hope that we get something soon or within the next year. Maybe 2024 Superman figures are going to see a drastic change. However, I'm not hurting this figure due to the body mold itself. I also wish that the chest logo was just a tad bit wider. I think it's a little too narrow compared to the comic image of this book, but it's also just that face. I actually cannot overlook that face. He's constantly squinting and smirking. I know I don't cuss in my videos, but he kind of looks like an ass. I'm just saying. That's just me. You might disagree, but hey, let me know down in the comments if you do. With all that said, though, guys, if you did enjoy what you saw here, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe if you're new. We try to put up at least 2 videos a week for you guys to enjoy. With all that said, though, guys, I'm getting out of here, and I will see you in the next video.